joining me. I'm Dr. Holland Meyer, and today we're going to talk about how everyone can get so excited about business, and that's very common, but you know what's rare? Endurance in business. That's rare, and that's the difference between having a successful business and a very short-lived business. I remember one of the businesses I started, it was starting a cookbook, and we were so excited. I had partners. We were so excited to get started with this cookbook business. We met. We were doing different recipes. We were taking pictures of food and doing all kinds of fun stuff for that. But then, you know, I had some things start getting in my head about a few things, and I'm going to share what that is with you, because I've taken inventory not only on this one business but a few businesses, as well as when I consult other folks in their business, that there's some very specific bullet points I want to share with you that limit our enthusiasm and that kind of allow our excitement to just kind of deflate a little bit. And I want to share that with you so that you don't run into these same problems. With this cookbook, one of the things that this was probably the biggest one, and it's negative self-talk or hearing negative talk from other people. One of the things that just kept replaying in my head is, you are not a cook. You don't even like to be in the kitchen. And while that is still very true, I know a lot of information and I know a lot, and I'm partnered with the right people that love to cook, and we could still deliver that information to you. But I had that negative self-talk that I don't even like to be in the kitchen. I don't even like to cook. I don't really have a major interest in this. And I allowed that to limit all the money that I've lost in that company the whole time that it could have been in a business. And some ways that I want you to work on battling your negative self-talk is to have a renewing of the mind and learn a new language. So put positive words of affirmation down, look in the Bible about what God says that you are. You're His masterpiece. And another thing I want to share with you is counter the negative with a positive. So anytime you have something negative to say about yourself, so for me, oh, I don't even like to be in the kitchen, I could say, but I have valuable information to share. So just try to deflect the negative things and really implement the positive things into there. And then also stretch outside of your comfort zone. So if you know that this isn't what you like to do, maybe just get in the kitchen with so for me, this book, get into the kitchen with the folks that love to do the work. And maybe you might love to take pictures instead of actually do the cooking. Maybe you want to tell them what parsley can actually do for them instead of actually doing the cooking. So we want to deflect the negative self-talk. The second one I want to share with you is, you might not, a lot of times we lose our excitement because we're not making enough money that we thought, or we're not making money fast enough. And so for us with this cookbook, we had a whole lot of work to do before it became a book, before we launched it, before we, you know, and all this stuff and the website, and there's so many moving parts that we never really let it come full circle to actually make money. And we lost our steam because we're not making money and just the excitement wasn't there and it was a long haul. And I just want to let you know that you've got to give it. In general, most businesses take about 5 years before they actually become profitable. And so you have to make it at least 18 months. You've got to commit to minimum 18 months. And also for me, this was a side project. I was not putting 100% full priority effort into this. So you have to make sure that your goals that you have are realistic for the effort that you're putting into it, and be realistic with yourself. And then the last point I want to make is, you're going to run into problems, frustrations, trials. You're going to run into these things that might limit you from having the endurance to see it through. So for us, it became timing. Okay, it became a lot of different things. And even in other businesses, sometimes partnerships didn't work out. It wasn't with the cookbook, with some other businesses, partnerships didn't work out. But if it's truly your vision and it's truly what God has called you to do, you've got to find a way to win. If it's partnerships, you got to cut the strings and keep moving with what God's called you to do. So I just want to leave you with a scripture, James 1:2-3. Consider it true joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Thanks for joining me today. If this had an impact on you, I want you to share it with your friends. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more information. Stay classy, folks.